Well, hello everyone. My name is Artix. I want to welcome you back to another episode of Ark Survival Evolved here on the Pooptopia server, where we're continuing our adventure here on the center map. Now you might be looking at the screen wondering, where am I? And what is this giant structure behind me? Well, I'm going to fill you in on all that. We are right above the base. It is actually, you can just barely see it, but that pillar right there, that is the center of the base. Well, not absolute center, but that's lined up with the bottom door of the workshop. In this building here, I was keeping our three collection dinos in because I want to put a resource hut up here. Now, ignore the gasoline because, well, I had to get some stuff and yeah. I took it out of the fabricator because I was constructing some stuff and I wanted to come up here and get some work done on this, so I brought all the gas with me so that it would keep building and then just run out. Now if you notice, all over this whole thing there are fence foundations. I've already laid out how I want this to work, and we've got most of the resources. I think everything except for some of the walls and part of the ceiling are in this storage chest in here. So we're gonna go ahead and get this laid out, but I wanna kinda bring you guys for a quick little tour, if you will. Obviously, this is gonna be an entrance. It looks like an entrance, so that's gonna be the entrance. Down here on this end, there's going to be a dino gate that's gonna take up these two foundations. There'll be ramps here, and it's going to span the entire section, and there'll be another dino gate with a door and ramps. That way you can walk your dinos in and out. Now each of these are stalls, so we'll probably have the Doty, the Beaver. I'm gonna be putting storage here, and then we'll have a deer, and I think I want to get a dire bear because they're pretty good on weight, so I need somebody to lug crap around with me. Excuse me. So then this door will probably come down. This will still have a door, and these will still have doors. That way you can access the storage from here. And then, So you're gonna have a door here. It's gonna be walled off, wall here, and another door here. So when you're coming in, you stop, offload all your stuff, and then you go put your dino up. Same thing with this side. Now the back here is still gonna have a door, and what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be building a landing pad for our flyers. They'll be big enough for a Quetzal to get in. Hey, get out of here. But we're going to build it big enough to land a Quetzal, so if we're down in the base and let's say, oh, well, crud, we need some metal. We fly up, we have a safe spot to land where our bird is protected instead of having to land out front like he is now. And then you just run in the back door, get your stuff, close everything up, and head back down. So I guess while I was explaining all that stuff, I could have been placing this. Now, it does get a little bit tricky with these dino gates. I mean, they are a little bit of a pain. And as you see, that's the fat side in. I want the skinny side in. So we're gonna keep trying to finagle it. Nope. You know what? Let's start up here. Okay, that's good. See, it's got these big wide fat ends. I want those on the outside. And then these skinny ends on the inside. Oh, excuse me. And that looks like it's going to be backwards. Yep. So see, it's kind of a pain to get these to snap correctly. I think that's correct. All right. So we got that much. And they're all gonna snap the wrong way. All right, so let me find one that is going to snap properly, or I guess at all right now, because then that will help the others. And see, when I build structures like the base, this is what I have to deal with. It is a gigantic pain in the butt. Oh, and I know you guys see the Dimorphodon on my shoulder. I was in the base, and she flew inside, and she's a 150. So I trained her and tamed her and don't have a name. So if you guys would be so kind, give me some naming ideas down in the comment section below, and let me know what you think. Here's what she looks like, in case that's going to factor into your decision at all. Pink and black with green wings. I thought it looked pretty cool. So, give me just a little bit to finagle all these into place, and then I'll bring you guys back whenever that's done. All right, see you in just a second. And we're back, everybody. And I haven't done anything besides place the dino gates. I want to keep you guys with me for the majority of this one. Now, some of it I am going to have to go do some gathering off camera because I didn't get all of it. But as you see, it makes a little bit more sense now. It's a lot easier to see with the gates in and the fence foundations. So this is just going to be a solid wall. There's nothing going to be over here. In one of these stalls, I'm thinking, because a bear isn't that big, that I'm probably going to slap a generator down and a feeding trough next to it, and then I may have some of the omnidirectional lights running down through here. But let's check this out. We're going to be putting in some vaults, because you can actually bunker these things down pretty good, and that's what I was afraid of. I was afraid that was going to be an issue. So we're going to have to go into K mode and make sure this is centered up here. Oh man, this is going to be a difficult one. I think that looks pretty good. It needs to come to the left a little bit, though. Okay, too much left. I just want to show you guys how bad it actually gets when I'm building. Let's just check this line here, see if that all matches up. That looks good there. That looks good there. All right, so now we got to try and get it centered up inside of here. Which, that right there looks pretty dang good. All right, so there is one storage placed. So now whenever you come in, you can just access it from the side, like so. And I'll have another one on the other side, and there'll be a dinosaur gate here. And then the back in here will just be regular walls. Which, thinking about it, I probably should have put in the walls first. So let's just see if it's gonna be a giant pain. Me and No Rush were messing around with these earlier, and that's exactly what they were doing. So let's try it. I mean, that looks right. But then arc happens. I don't know why. Couldn't begin to tell you. Ooh, wrong Ingram. So let's try it from out here. Okay, it worked that time. And that time. Cool. So I'm just gonna wall this section off, and I'm gonna leave the top open because I've got something I want to show you guys. It's a mod that we have installed, and I didn't know about it, or I would have been using it quite a bit by now. It's pretty amazing. I like it, and it's just for building. It doesn't change things around. Why, Ark? Why? All right. So now from here, right there, nailed it. All right, so let's get this walled off. We'll get this other vault set. Okay, close enough. All right, so we'll go here, drop into K mode. It is all kinds of crooked. Well, let's get it somewhat aligned. Bring it to the right a little. Too much right. That looks good there. So hard to do using the K camera. Okay, he needs to come a little more to the left. There we go. Now it looks pretty good, so I'm gonna drop it. Alright, we got our storage in place. Cool. Alright, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go around and drop all the walls so that we can get it sealed off and secured, and then I'll bring you guys right back for that. Alright, everybody, and we're back. Sorry, I thought I seen a raptor over there. But as you can see, everything is slowly starting to take shape. Now, this is where the mod stuff comes in. Nope, that's a vault room. Might have to put up some signs or something. But if you were doing this vanilla, you could just stretch the walls right here all the way to the top. But we have the Structure Plus mod, and I didn't know about these. And crap. I'm gonna have to build a ladder or something to get up there. But we actually have windows. Those have glass in them. I know it doesn't look like it, but what I'm probably gonna do, I don't know, I may leave it like that, or I may just have bottom board or something, I'm not sure. But you guys know that I like having natural light in the base. Now, I'm not 100% certain if I have enough of these. Probably not, but if not, I'll go make some more off camera, because I'm not going to make you guys watch me craft and stuff. And I'm not going to have enough. So we need, what, one? Open. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, 7's not too bad. Now, the other part of the mod that we're going to use, and this is what I'm going to show you guys. We have these Dino Gate glass walls. Now, okay, I have to switch it to manual. What's cool about these is they have the same health as a regular gate. See, 7,500, 7,500, and I think this one's a standard. Yep, oh no. So they actually have just a little bit more health than your regular dinosaur gates. But the cool thing with these glass is, you can see through it on both sides. Well, you can cycle the glass. So you see through here, but you black it out here. Which, I think is pretty neat. You can actually cycle it to where you can't see out, but you can see in. Or you could cycle it to where it's no way. You just have black, which is kind of cool. Then you have just your standard opaque. But what I want to do, I did see a raptor out there. What level are you? Ooh, 135. You know what? Bring it. Come on, lady raptor. Come on. Where are you at? There you are. Come get me. Come on, girl. No? Nothing? Ah! Frames. Yeah, get you some of that ascended pipe. You know what? Suck it, raptor. Yeah. Server safe. Maybe? No? Okay. Maybe it was just frames. Sorry. I don't have the greatest CPU, or the greatest computer in the world, guys, so I have to, you freaking kidding me? Get away from my... What is it with the 140s and such? You'll have to forgive me. I don't have the greatest computer in the world. So, it can, is he attacking? No. But he is... He is now. Yep, go ahead and goo absolutely nothing. You know what? I'm sick and tired of your crap, Dillo. Oh, man. Get off my freaking Quetzal. Alright, back to what I've been trying to tell you. I don't have the greatest computer in the world, so you guys are going to have to bear with me. I am looking at upgrading here very soon. but for now, we're stuck with this. Okay. So I'm thinking... Oh, I forgot to put a door frame in there. Or a gate frame. Oops. Cycle that switch it to manual, close it. Perfect. Now, I think that actually, and the glass up there, you can do the same tint with it. But that actually doesn't look bad at all. So, let me get this last one here set. And then I'm going to go make another gate frame, get the last one set, and get started on the roof. Now what I'm going to do for the inside, so I'm just going to do a standard flat roof with regular ceilings. Nothing fancy, and then we'll go up top and do some slopes and things like that. But give me just a little bit to get this done up, and I'll bring you guys back here soon. And we're back, everybody. And while I was down at the base getting some things done, poor Mr. Thatch Machine got killed. Rest in peace, Mr. T. But I went ahead and got all the windows done all the way around the base, and then I got a glass dino gate set up in between, and it's see-through on both sides. And I went ahead and put Rock Crusher and Woody up, because these freaking raptors on this map, oh my goodness, the spawns. So that's about how they would sit. I'm probably going to move NRG's collection dinos up here if he wants them. I'll have to check with him first, but we can store everything up here because we've got the metal nodes and we've got rock that we can use for stone and metal. We've got trees, we've got pretty much everything we need up here, which is why I'm building this, well, little shack style building. But I'm gonna go ahead and get started on the let's get you back. Perfect. Yep. Alright. And then NRG was out doing a loot run. He found a ramshackle assault rifle. So I've been playing around with it, and it's pretty fun, guys. Okay. Well, that was interesting. Go ahead and get these ramps dropped right here just to make it a little bit easier to get our dinos in and out. And we're gonna have to go tame another deer. This time we'll go for a high level one, at least 100 plus. Maybe we'll go 130 plus. I don't know yet, haven't decided. Now the tricky part, where's my ceilings? So more than likely what I'm gonna have to do I have, no I do not. Maybe they're on the Quetzal. I'm gonna have to probably build a couple of thatch ceilings, like those ones. And what do we need for ladders? Well, we have a ladder. Well, we're probably gonna need more. This one a bit, it'd probably be three. Okay, I don't have any fiber with me. And what I've been trying to do is preserve like the bushes and the trees and things like that closest to the base, because I think where it's at is a fairly pretty location, and I don't want to screw that up. All right, that's good enough on the fiber. Ladder. One. Oh, I need more wood. Wow. Frames are killing me today, guys. I am very sorry about that. Yeah, two should be enough to get up there. We'll have to take a look-see here in a minute. I don't know if... Oh, yeah. Okay, we're good. That's what I was worried about. I didn't know if we could reach by jumping. Now that we should be able to. There we go. Perfect. So since this is how this one placed, we're just going to carry it all the way across. Nothing fancy. It's just going to be a big box for right now. And then I'll be adding a slope section. I may be able to, I don't know, I might put something up here, but probably not. maybe a feeding trough or something like that. Oh, no, come on, Art. Oh, wait, that's because they're all wrong. Alright, guys, give me a minute. I'm gonna get. Oh, wait, no, they're not all wrong. This is all wrong. See, you guys are distracting me. Alright, give me a little bit. I'm gonna get all these ceilings placed and I'll be right. I will bring you right back. Wow, I can't even talk today. Oh, why, Ark? Why? Nah, never mind. I already know. Because of Ark. Alright. I will see you guys here in just a minute. And we're back. And I'm just trying to kind of take a look here and see how I want to do this. And I think... I'm not entirely sure how well this is going to work. Please, thank you. Come here. Perfect. Kind of what I'm thinking... I want to do this little section right here separate. I want the slopes to be... come on. Like that. No. No, not like that. Not like that at all. Okay. No, that's backwards. Anyway, you see what I'm saying. I want the crest to be running this way. But on this one, I want the crest to be running... this way. So let's just work on this side for right now. Okay, like so. And we may go ahead and do a thatch wall up there. Not sure yet. Okay, so. Not sure how this is gonna work. Let me just try to get some of these run down here. Nope, I don't need that. Alright. So, let's see here. I kinda wanna bring you guys with me so you can see my thought process behind everything and see how much I rage out on this game. Alright, so I want it like so. Okay, this should be fine. Yeah, that'll work out perfect. Okay. I think I've got those backwards. And yep, I do. Okay. So let's take these down. This is what's great about the Structure Plus. I can just sit here and take it down instead of having to remake it. It saves me a lot of time, but it also costs me in levels, unfortunately. Okay, so like so. Come on. And like so. Perfect. Then we'll try this. That? Oh, night. Ark. Why? Okay. No. Quit hitting that button. Alright. So that's going to go like that. And then I want these to snap off like so. Now, what I may go ahead and do. Yeah. Yeah, I like that. Okay. Ah, wrong button again. Dadgummit Quetzal. But yeah, when I build guys, I want them to look good. I want you guys to like them. And I also rage out a lot. And I have the ceilings that hide quite a bit of stuff, as you can see. But coming up here towards the front, not gonna make it. Oh, wow, I did make it. Cool. Let's see, you go there. You go there. I'm gonna have to get some more of these, but we'll pop down here and let you guys take a look at it. It'd be more like that. And I plan on extending off the dino gates just a little bit so there's an overhang so it doesn't just look like a call tower with a point. So, let me get that going, and I'll bring you guys back. Welcome back, everyone. And I think we've got it done for the most part. There's no lighting in it, but unfortunately I'm going to have to rework the whole electrical system because I want to put a feeding trough in, and since it's one of the powered feeding troughs, it won't reach all the way down to where Rock Crusher's at. And the reason it says it's unpowered is because I have no gasoline in here. I'll get that took care of. I did put in a forge so it can make its own. We'll just have to move some stuff up here periodically. Actually, you know what? We've got El Gasoline right there. So we'll just plop that in, go there, turn on. There we go. And now it is powered. So what I'm probably going to have to do is move that, maybe put a hatch frame or something right here. I'm not 100% certain yet, but maybe put a hatch frame, put the feeding trough and the generator up there, and then as far as lighting goes, we can just use auto torches. I'll get that part figured out here after a while. But I did want to take you guys down to the base real quick. Hopefully the computer doesn't bug out because it absolutely hates my base. I was out doing some grinding, and don't mind the giant pillar that was for this project, but it didn't work out. While I was out doing some grinding, getting things together, I found some plant species X seeds. And so I went and stuck them each on these corners here. And yeah, hopefully they'll help keep the base protected. I've got one on each corner, so if anything does fall in back, hopefully it'll kill it. But I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. But anyways, guys, that's going to be it for this episode. I hope you did enjoy watching. And if you did, smash that thumbs up button. And as always, if you haven't subscribed already, please do. I work very hard on these videos just for you guys. And I'd love to hear your feedback down in the comments section. Excuse me. So yeah, guys, that's going to be it. And until next time, have a good one. Tell me pretty lies, look me in the face, tell me that you love me.